In this video, we're going to look at the ratio test. And the ratio test is a method to help determine whether the series sum of an from n equals 1 to infinity converges or diverges. Okay, it's one of many tests or one of many methods you can use to see if a series is convergent or divergent. It doesn't always give the answer, but in some cases it is very helpful. So the idea is we have to calculate this what we call L, which is the limit, which is the limit as n tends to infinite of the modulus of a n plus 1 over the modulus of a n. So this is what we have to do for the ratio test. And then there's three options. If L is less than 1, then the series, again, this is the sum of a n equals 1 to infinite, is convergent. Actually, it's actually absolutely convergent, which is a special case of convergency. But for now, we'll just say it's convergent. If L is greater than 1, this series is divergent, so it doesn't tend to a limit. And if L is equal to 1, the test provides no information. On convergence. And the reason is there are cases where L equals 1 where the series diverges. There are other cases where L equals 1 and the series converges. So we would, in those examples, we would need a different test. So here we go, let's try this test on an example. E.g., consider, so we're going to have the sequence given by an equals n over e to the n. Okay. Then L is the modulus of an plus 1. I missed the lim. L is the limit as n tends to infinite of the modulus of an plus 1 over the modulus of an. Okay. Now, because n over e to the n, these are both positive numbers, then the modulus of an plus 1 is just an plus 1, and the modulus of an is just an. So this is exactly n plus 1 over e to the n plus 1, all over n over e to the n. Okay, so we can simplify this algebra a bit, and we get this is the same as the limit as n tends to infinite of, this will turn into n plus 1 over n times e to the n over e to the n plus 1. Just sort of rearranging that fraction. And this is the same as lim as n tends to infinite of n plus 1 over n, and e to the n over e to the n plus 1 is 1 over e. And as n tends to infinite, then n plus 1 over n tends to 1. So this thing is equal to this. The limit of this is just 1 over e. It's 1 times 1 over e, which is 1 over e. And this is less than 1. So therefore, the sum of n equals 1 to infinite of n over e to the n is convergent. Because our ratio test, our L, was less than 1. Okay. Similarly, e.g., consider an equals e to the n over n. It's the same thing, but just flipped over. Well, then L is equal to the lim of, as n tends to infinite, of, now it's the same thing, but flipped over, so it's e to the n plus 1 over n plus 1 over e to the n over n. And unsurprisingly, we just get 1 over our previous limit. So this is just e, which is greater than 1. Therefore, this sequence, this series, n, the sum from n equals 1 to infinite of e to the n over n, is divergent. So we've done 2 examples there. One with a convergent series and one with a divergent series. Again, it should be pretty obvious that these series are going to be convergent and divergent just by looking at the numbers. But here's a good proof using the ratio test. Okay, now let's look at one of these more complicated cases. Let's consider the sequence an is 1 over n. Okay, then L equals, again, lim as n tends to infinite of an plus 1, that's 1 over n plus 1, over an, or so I say it's the modulus of an plus 1, again, because these are all positive numbers, it's the same as just an plus 1 over an. So 1 over n plus 1 over 1 over n is just n over n plus 1. And the limit as n tends to infinite of n over n plus 1 is just 1. So we have an example now where L is 1. And if you remember, for the ratio test, if L equals 1, this is inconclusive. Therefore, ratio test is inconclusive. We need a different method. Inconclusive. In fact, this series is a well-known series. It's called the harmonic series. And the sum of 1 over n is divergent. It's a well-known divergent series called the harmonic series. Okay, let's also consider an equals 1 over n squared, then L equals lim as n tends to infinite of one over n plus one squared over one over n squared, and this is equal to n squared over n plus one squared, which again tends to 1 as n tends to infinite. Therefore, ratio test is inconclusive. In fact, sum of 1 over n squared, 1 to infinite, is convergent. So the point is, here we have 2 examples where L equals 1, one of which is a divergent series and the other is a convergent series. The ratio test doesn't give you any information when L equals 1.